evening, everyone. Welcome to the Cantor Theater in the Paulson Center. I'm Jonathan Haas, director of the NYU Percussion Program. And to my left is Deborah Damast, who is director of dance education. We are in music and performing arts professions in the Steinhardt School. And welcome to what I think you're going to find to be an exceptional evening combining dance and percussion ensemble. Strange combination, perhaps, but not really. The inspiration for Kabalek in writing The Eight Inventions actually came from his having heard Stravinsky's lesser known but amazing work called Les Noces, which was a piece originally intended to be danced to, choreographed and danced to, which was for a percussion ensemble, four pianos, a choir, and vocal soloists. Kabalek was very much influenced by the times that he lived in, post-World War II. I think you'll hear many of those influences. And I think what is also really of interest about the first piece is that it was originally written for the percussion ensemble De Strausberg, which was the first percussion ensemble, professional percussion ensemble, in the history of our percussion music. I really want to especially thank all of the students in the dance program and in our percussion program, the percussion ensembles in the pit. So let's give them a warm welcome also. And before I give Deborah the microphone, because I have to take sort of a long walk to get myself back into that pit, this is really, I think, what we do best at NYU, which is to collaborate. For me to be able to call Deborah at a moment's notice and say, hey, you want to do something really cool? And all I got was an immediate response, you bet, let's do this. So welcome. You'll meet our choreographer and composer of the second work this evening, and they're going to say a couple words about their piece. But before that, enjoy the Kabalek and Deborah Damast.
Thanks, Jonathan. This is such a privilege and an honor to work with the percussion ensemble. Oftentimes, we don't have the luxury of working with live musicians, and so we're pressing play on our machines. And this opportunity to be in this new, beautiful space with these esteemed musicians and with friends from our department is really a joy. And I just want to extend thanks to also the production team here who has pulled together for us to be here in this new space. Thank you, production team. So the piece that you're about to see, as Jonathan mentioned, was composed after World War II and is a response to what the feeling and what was happening in Europe at the time. And our title for it in the dance piece is called Sandstorm. And if you imagine sort of a post-apocalyptic group of women on another planet who have inherited the whatever it is, Earth, that they're now inhabiting, it is about warriors, it's about resistance, it's about persistence and perseverance. And the things that we can show in our art, that we can create in our art together, don't yet exist except in our minds, and then we translate that through our artists. We did this piece first in 2015, so this is a recreation of a piece that we did together. We performed it at the Lowe Theater, we performed it at Juilliard, and almost 10 years later, we're reimagining and reconstructing it. I wanted to note that I choreographed the sections that you are going to see in this first piece, except for one solo. You will see the most exquisite dancer, Xin Yi Zheng. She is the choreographer of the second piece you're going to see, a recent graduate of the dance education program, and she's a phenom. So it's a way of introducing her to you through the solo in this piece that she choreographed, and the rest is mine. So I hope you enjoy this night. Thank you, Jonathan, so much for allowing us to be part of this.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the second half. I've asked Shigi, our choreographer, and Pius Cheng, the composer of the next piece, to say a couple words about their collaboration and how they put this together. But before I do that, I'd like to let everyone know that the principal soloist in this piece is Erica Dymo. And Erica Dymo has been, has been the leadership at NYU in regards to marimba studies and mallet studies for so many years, and has helped me build one of the most essential mallet programs perhaps anywhere in the world. But regardless, that her spirit of joyful spirit of learning, of coming to NYU from Portland, Oregon, which is a small commute, super commute, I want to recognize her and thank her for everything that she has done and continues to do for us at NYU. So you will hear one of the most exceptional marimbas in the world. Thank you. So this project, this concert, and especially Pius's piece, Heaven on Earth, we've been talking about this, I think, well, before COVID. That's gone, bye-bye. And here we are now ready to be a part of this magnificent work that I was introduced to first through Erico, and Erico and Pius, by the way, are married with a beautiful daughter. So Pius and Shigi, would you please join me on stage? In fact, I'm just gonna go find a seat. Come on out. How'd you do that?
I'm magic.
Thank you, Jonathan.
Thank you.
So,
go first.
Ladies first.
Oh, okay. Good evening. My name is Xinyi Zhang. I'm alumni of NYU Dance Education Program. Woo! And also, I'm a choreographer of Heaven and the Earth. This choreography reflects the harmonious relationship between the nature and the human, and I incorporate with five Chinese elements, which is metal, wood, water, fire, and the earth. In one piece, I put a math story from Shanghai Jing. You will see. Hope you can enjoy the show, and welcome to, to the scene. Oh, sorry. Let's go by. Yeah.
Thank you, Xinyi.
Yeah. Thank you.
Are you leaving me alone? Okay, thank you. Moral support. Hi, I'm Pius. Thank you for coming to the show. I did not get into NYU, so don't judge me. But we're good friends now, so that's great. And like Jonathan said, Erica is my boss, my wife. I love you. And thank you for having me here. It's a great honor working with all these musicians, all these dancers. It's been an incredible week here at NYU. Thank you to Jonathan and Deborah and Xinyi, of course, for the choreography and all the students and dancers. I don't have much to say about the piece that Xinyi didn't already say. It's Heaven and Earth. First, there's the heavenly Erico, and then there's the earthly me. And this is a story about how she fell in love with me. Yes? No, she's rolling her eyes at me. I'm too scared to look backstage. I think their movement titles, it tells you the story, heaven, and then angels dancing, and then earth, which is, and then, what's after that? Time, time begins, and then there's birth, and then comes mankind. And then after that is union, which is a romantic duet. And then after that is finale, we end with a bang. So I hope you enjoy it. It's an 8 minutes, about 40 minutes long. So sit back and enjoy, and we'll see you in 40 minutes.